Hello, everyone, and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name is Leigh Fuge, and I'm here today with musicteacher.com. And in this lesson, we're going to talk about the importance of alternate picking, and I'm going to give you five exercises to improve your alternate picking today. The tones you're hearing in this video are coming from my 1985 Kramer Striker, which is plugged into the Black Star Studio 10 6L6. The drive you're hearing is coming from a combination of the amp running on a just broken up tone and the Wampler gearbox pushing a little bit more drive into the front end, and the amp is running via the two notes torpedo captor X. So alternate picking is the art of picking both down and up on the guitar. This improves your speed and your fluency when you're playing. Many players, when they first start out, will often only pick one direction, which is either going to be down or up. This is just the comfort thing all guitar players do when they first start. When you start to alternate pick and you're mixing down and up, it can be quite tricky sometimes to get your hands to coordinate and lock in. So in this lesson, we're going to talk about five exercises, and they're going to range in difficulty from very, very simple if you're just starting out with alternate picking, through to some more complex ones, which are going to be crossing different string groupings for the more advanced players who are looking to just take their alternate picking to the next level. So the first exercise is going to be all on the high E string. I'm going to be playing 16th notes for this, which is four notes on a beat. I'm going to be playing groups of four with everything I play. So I'm going to start off with the fifth fret, and I'm going to play that four times, down, up, down, up. And then I'm going to go to an open high E string, down, up, down, up. That's my second beat. So it's one, four times, open, four times. My third beat is going to be the seventh fret. I'm going to play that four times. And then I'm going to go to the open high E and play that four times on my fourth beat. You'll notice that I'm not picking this very fast. I'm focusing on clear notes and also consistent rhythm. I want all my notes to be the same length. For the second half of the exercise, we're going to come up to the eighth fret. We're going to play that four times, then go to an open string. That's the first two beats in the second bar. And then we're going to do the seventh fret to the open once more. If I put that together, the good thing with this is you don't have to do it at speed to get benefit from this. You can do this really slow and then build up the speed as you become more comfortable. The idea is to get every pick stroke the same intensity and consistent rhythmically. You don't want your picking to be fluctuating in note length and speed. You want to get it as tight as possible. So as a result, you can do all of these exercises with a metronome. When you do start to speed that up, it's going to sound something like this. The second exercise takes the same form, but this time we're going to be playing the fretted note once on the beat, and then we're going to be playing open notes for the other three notes that we're playing on each beat. So the first grouping is going to be the fifth fret, followed by three opens. So that's my first beat. Now what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be moving the fretted note on each beat. So on the first bar, I'm going to do 5, 7, 8, 10. That's my ascending part. Then I'm going to be coming backwards, 12, 10, 8, 7. So here is how that looks when we lay it all out. So the first beat is going to be 5 and 3 opens. Then we're going to keep ascending. Now we're in the second bar, so we're coming up to the 12th fret and we're descending. And all together. There's no right or wrong way to place your fingers for that one. You can do the entire exercise with one finger. And then you can mix up which finger you're using, or you can use a combination of fingers as you saw me do earlier on. The third exercise is when we start to talk about crossing over strings. So this is actually quite a simple exercise to get started with if you're new to alternate picking and you want to get good at crossing between the strings. We're just going to take an A minor pentatonic scale, and we're going to alternate pick from the root note all the way up the scale and back down again. So So you'll notice I was doing strict alternate picking there on every single note. This is a great one to do slow because we get used to crossing between those strings. Then you can use a metronome to gradually speed this one up. For this one, I'm just doing two notes per beat. So if you're doing this with a metronome, it's going to be two notes on every click. The fourth exercise we're going to look at is the lick that I played at the very start of this video. So this is also going to be using that A minor pentatonic scale shape. We're going to be doing this descending. But we're going to be pushing the technicality a little bit here. So here we're going to be working with triplets, which is three notes on a beat. One and a, two and a, three and a, four and a. But we're going to be descending the scale in groups of six. So we're going to be doing a group of six across two beats. So each bar of this is going to have 12 notes. So this is a lick that sounds great when you speed it up. But for your initial learning of this, it's great to play it slow because it works on your ability to count different subdivisions across beats. But it's also great for your pick moving back and forth between strings. So on the first beat, I'm starting from the highest note of the scale and I'm descending by three notes. That gets me to the eighth fret on the B string. And then on the second beat, I'm going from the fifth of the B down to the fifth of the G. So when you hear this played in full, it sounds exactly the way you heard it at the start of the video, which is like this. So it sounds pretty quick, but really it's just this grouping. And we're moving this grouping around in different ways. So on the first two beats, we're going from the eighth of the E down to the fifth of the G. Triplets, one and a, two and a. Once we get there, the third beat starts on the eighth fret of the B string, but I'm doing exactly the same thing. I'm coming down six notes, three strings across two beats. Then I'm in the second bar from the seven of the G. And then the third beat of the second bar from the seven of the D. So it's literally the same rhythmic grouping coming down the strings, one string at a time. So we're starting from the E, stepping to the G, B to D, G to A, D to E. It sort of cascades from high to low. So when we play this slowly, it sounds like this. And then when we speed it up, it works as a great rock lick. You can also work on this one ascending as well. So you could just start from the low E string, work up to the 7 of the D, go back to the 5th on the A, and repeat the same sort of pattern structure. The 5th and final exercise is going to be the most demanding one. This is going to be using the A major scale in a fully fretted position like this. So we're going from the 5th fret of the low E string. So I'm playing 5, 7, and 9 on the E and A strings. 6, 7, and 9 on the D and G. And 7, 9, and 10 on the B. That's a full two octaves of the A major scale in a fully fretted position. So this one is a lot trickier. So here's what I'm going to play in full, and then we'll break it down. So we're once again working with triplets here, but now we're working with what are known as 16th note triplets. So there's two triplets on each beat, so six notes per beat. So we're actually breaking this down into double string pairs, and we're using triplets to go up and down at the same time. So once you understand the pattern of this, it's actually much easier to put the whole thing together. So on the first beat, I'm doing 5, 7, and 9 on the low E string, so that's an ascending triplet. Then I'm coming up to the 5 on the A, and I'm descending, so it's 5 on the A, 9 and 7 on the E. So that's my first beat. Then I'm running up again from the 5 on the E and the 5 on the A. So it's up, down, up, up. So it's ascending on the first triplet, so in this case 5, 7, 9. Then we skip to the 5 on the A, but we descend, so 5, 9, 7. We go back to the root again, 5, 7, 9, and then on the A, 5, 7, 9. So it's going to be ascending, skip up to the next note but descend, then ascend for the last two. Now, once you understand that pattern, then you're just applying that across each pairing of strings. So on the first string pair, which is across the first two beats of the first bar, it's this. Then for the next string pairing, we're just starting from the fifth fret of the A string, we're doing the same thing. The only difference here is instead of the fifth on the next string, it's going to be the sixth. That gets us up to the 9 and the D. So the first bar, slowly. This sounds great when you start to speed it up as well. So we can just carry this on now up the entire scale. So we've landed on the 9th fret of the D string. So our next string pairing is going to start from the 6th fret of the D. So it's that same pattern again, but now we're just working with different notes. And then the final pairing is going to be 6, 7, 9 on the G, 7, 9, 10 on the B. So this pairing is slightly more difficult because we do have that 1 fret shift as well. And that brings us to the end of our second bar. So here's the second half of that. So that's quite a long alternate picking exercise. Now, we are talking about 6 notes on a beat here. You can do this as triplets across a slower click as well if you're doing that with a metronome. You don't have to focus it in on 6 per beat. You could drag this out into a 4-bar exercise instead of a 2-bar. So here it is in full, played slowly. And then once more, a little faster. So there you go, there are 5 alternate picking exercises for you guys to get stuck into that will improve your alternate picking, whether you're a brand new player to the world of alternate picking, or you've been doing it a while and you just want to take it to that next level, those exercises should help. There will be a link down below in the description where you can see all of the tabs for each of these exercises as well, so please go check that out. Don't forget to let us know down below how you've gotten on with this, and if there's any other topics you'd like to see us talk about in these videos, please let us know down below in the comments as well. Don't forget to go check out PMTV UK over on YouTube for more free video lessons just like this one. And if you're looking for a guitar teacher in your local area, please head to musicteacher.com. Check out the Music Teacher database. There's a great network of teachers all around the country waiting to help you guys out. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you very soon.